Holy calamity, scream insanity, or are you ever gonna be another great fan of me? Boom!
Okay. That was more 9-3 this time. Okay, you've got these cuts, and we're just gonna go through them all. Whether I talk or not, or remember to talk, is a different story, but I mean, straight off with ones, polyboards, you're gonna go straight away with these, aren't you? So there's no debate about it. Been saying this on, well, on the last video, what I'm taking for granted is every time I'm using any of the boards you'll see, I'll put the board in, put the tile in, template will go against the wall, and then before I go, my left hand is always pulling down and the right hand always pushes against the template. Now I keep my finger on the weight to stop it from moving anywhere, and it has become just like a second nature action for me, which it will do for you guys the more you use them. But to start off with, you know, anything out of the normal is always awkward, so you just got to remember, pull it down, because it just makes sure it's on the board. Left hand pulls down, right hand pushes up against it, knuckle on there, pull across. Okay, now this one. Holy board, it's not going to work, is it? Because there, you can't take it to the right, you haven't got one to go in there to set that up for that. I mean, there are ways of doing that, but in these cases, this is where the 3-inch rock board comes. Now, like I said in the other video, all these boards, every single one of them, everything is the same. It's the template, isn't it? It's the drop. And it is sort of based on the back marking, but not the back marking as in tile on tile that everyone's used to and that lot. We used to do the short scribe all the time, but we'll go into that on another one, otherwise I'm going to drift off. But basically, when everyone sort of get confused on the boards, it's really, it's just one board. But, you know, in this case, this is a perfect one to get that hit because it's the best one that fits. The others ain't gonna fit. Another one will fit on there, but it's always the same. But I'll do a little video, basically what I mean about the short scribe, but that's what the tools are based on. Most hardcore liars are gonna know that one. Now all these are taking it square on, you know. Whenever you're facing the wall when it's going across, it's always straight lay, isn't it? You know, this rule never changes. You know, that's how it works with the board. So again, on this one, you're gonna go with a 3-inch rock board again. I mean, it's a great board for these ones because it really does lock it in. You've got 2 hands free, you know, this is, it's solid, no balancing, no nothing, just push that across. The only problem with compressor fitment, it does come in tight. Oops. Right, okay, so now this one, an option could be there if we're lucky, you know, to get the holly board in there, but no, she's not going to go in there. So holly board is off the table. 3-inch lock board, 3-inch lock board off the table. Lock right is going to be the one that's perfect for that plank, isn't it? And that is basically all it is, because I mean, that one will fit in. The only reason all the other boards got invented was because I went and done a job and I come across a cut I couldn't get. Now, in this one, you have got both of them again, but what's in front of you going across is that bad boy. Anything to the angles or the sides is the 45 template. With the rules, we should all be getting the rules now. If it's not square, you just adapt what you're doing. Or just the line up. You know, we've got a new one now. If you don't want to double bubble check it, you get the mighty pipe finder 3 out. Just get us a little stab mark on her. So then when you're putting your template on there, you know, that's showing that that's got to come up there. So that's showing it's miles off it. So I'm going to double check that. I'll check that on this side, actually. So I'm going to use the end of the board as a square. Or I'll get my Jeff square on it. I'm only double checking because that was alarmingly off. So... Now, well, she's saying she's pretty much bang on almost, so God knows what happened with the other mark there, but these sort of things can happen. So, anyway, we caught it in time. This wall's a little bit off, but I bet you I'm going to see my mark on there somewhere. There's the bottom of that stab mark in there. But it's no dramas anyway, so if you know that field is off, you're just going to put it on there. That's where it was. Adjust that line up to there a little bit. If you had more cuts going down there, you'd mark them all on the same line because the wall would be the same degrees out. But again, these are not what you call dramas. So now we're back on track. Okay. I'm going to start moving on to these ones. So, got another quick, easy, straight one there. You can use whatever board you want on that one, can't you? So, you can keep with the 3-inch lock boards. Again, going square across that template. Push against the wall with my right, pull down with my left so that is tight. I'm going to pull that across there. I've got a real good deep score on there. Okay, so now this one, we've got several ways of attacking it. Okay. So you can go with your normal cherry board. Line up on there. Now you've only got that wall there. It's going to be the straight edge, but the rest are all angles, aren't they? So Now, Shane, it's going to obviously be another piece in there. So you probably want to put that piece on there anyway, aren't you? So. The only one I'm really going to be really sure on here is going to be the straight lay one, but we're going to check the others. Sod. Okay, right. Yeah. Because I don't know about those rolls, if I really just want to double check it. You have got it in position, but what you are going to know is that that one is right. You're going to know that that one is now going to be. Okay. Yeah, so that could be those ones. Just this one there, so I'm just going to go to my line now. Now, is this going to show? This one's been big now as well. Where these cutting mats are worth their weight in gold, because look, now I can pull that onto there, you know, and I can really just take that little bit off to get her in there. No matter where you're going to be, you're always going to get these bastard cuts at some point. So, that's that bit done. We're going to break that in the video now. We're just going to come up this wall as well, then we're going to come all the way around there. Talking about them as we go, if I can remember.